guy, my son Vach. He's on my tickets. And we are going to, what we have done is, we're getting the value of glucose level, blood glucose level, and get the data and we convert into the PC, produce as a PCM signal, right? That to, waveform to, waveform to PCM signal, that we have display, we draw a graph with that signal, okay?
Basic idea behind this application is we have a peripheral device which has some sensor, actually it has a sensor in which the sensor electrodes has ferrocyanide and our blood will pass into the first layer, that is it will be given as a counter electron and it will pass to the next electron, so that the two conducting plates will be there, so that it will produce some electrons and the flow of electrons we will get some of the PWM, that is pulse width modulated output. We will get some pulse width modulated output from this peripheral device. Absolutely, we missed to bring the peripheral device. Anyway, our good luck, we bring samples of the peripheral device and we go for a scratch that we need to optimize the quantizing error. Because we are giving the PWM, that is pulse width modulated signal in the audio into the mobile phone. We are the audio jack. So when it enters into the audio jack, it will be as an analog input and we need to convert again into the raw signal and we need to show it as a graph and to store the value in the SD card or some other else, we need to encode it into the PCM signal. So in this type of conversions, we occur various quantizing. First thing is, whenever we are converting a signal for ADC or DAC or something else, what are the conversion takes place, sure there will be some data loss. The same thing happens here. While sampling, we need to quantize and while quantizing, we have some quantizing error. While coming here and we have gone for the scratch and absolutely our entire idea is to build the app, but when come to this hack night, our good luck, we have built a optimizing quantizing algorithm here. That's the thing. Quantizing error algorithm has been proposed in this hack night and we are happy to say that 20% of error we have reduced here. In such case, we have taken a sampling PWM signal. What I have told before, I have bring the PWM signal. In that PWM signal, the major part rolls with the mid values, that is 0.5. And with that PWM signal, the algorithm generation credits will go to my friend and he will explain more about it.
Well, as he told, we had to convert a PWM, which was received as an analog signal, into a PCM for storing in SD card and then back to PWM for plotting in future. See, one analog to digital will have a lot of loss of data, but two will hardly get about 50% of the data. So I was like, okay, we can use something like as simple as Nyquist sampling ratio, but then as we searched on it, it is kind of difficult because sampling in amplitude is not as easy as sampling in time. So then I thought, okay, why should we search what someone has already done? So we sat together, all of us, and then we brainstormed and we came up with an algorithm and this has got really good results. So once the computer is loaded, I'll just show it to
actually
you.
We have more than 10 lakhs of samples in PWM signal what we sampled and we compared this with first we have done this PWM signal sampled by the MATLAB. So that, this is a story what behind us creating this algorithm. First of all, we created the samples, what we got is, we have put it in the MATLAB and we have tried out it and We got the OIP points and the NS and the Nyquist ratio what you have been given is the sampling rate of 44,100. Then after something we have done some modulation technologies and inbuilt that show the algorithm that what we have derived now step by step. In first step we have divided it by 1000 and we have rounded off the values. And again we have done some of the foolish things and again we got the wrong outputs. Then again we go ahead with the other ways and we found some of the rounding values and whether we have at last we came to came that the MATLAB is working fine. When our team has came for a video capture, we got the output in the MATLAB. When we go and implement into the Java using that Android, we got stuck up in that modulation. That is mod of some values have given there, and we got stuck up in that. And we don't know the function that is IEEE function.
This
is
one of the question actually. Isn't it actually easier to use a digital device?
See, the thing is, like you told, already PWM to PCM converters, there are a lot of ICs which do this. But like I told you, there is a lot of data loss. I mean, any A2D device, however ideal it is, will have a data loss because you are dropping the potential between two comparators. So it's a passive element, there's going to be a data loss. So I'll just show you how we actually went through this. See, the basic idea of this is, whenever there's a conversion, the maximum error is always in the midpoint. So,
time
comes into 1 minute? Yeah, 1 minute is fine. So, I'll just show you two things. One is the actual data set, but that is not really good to get a feel of. Then I'll show you something really nice. Okay. This is the signal, like he told, this is the signal you get from the peripheral device. Like you see, there are so many samples, you can hardly make out anything from it. And this is the reconstructed signal, which you can see is almost same. I mean, you might say that how will I know whether it's same or not, but you can see here, the mean squared error, if I just took the normalized value, is going to be something like 7.62 in 10 power minus 4. But based on an algorithm, now we are able to achieve something like 6.22 into 10 power minus 4 for this. But again, these are just numbers. You can only believe it if you see it from your eyes. So I'll just show you a little better plot which you can appreciate. And just 1 second. Good. So this is a sine wave from 0 to pi as you can see it. Now I will show you the normalized sine wave, which is going to be something like this, which is the quantized sine wave, which is like a Qutub Minar for you. And now, after our data sampling, this is what we get. From the picture, you can see that this, anyone can see and you can tell this is more like a sine wave rather than a Qutub Minar. So this was the result of our work for about 4 to 5 hours of continuous brainstorming. And we hope to implement this algorithm more widely in future. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we are not experts in sampling, so we don't have. Yeah, Mr.
Thanks, Krupp.